Hello friends, welcome to Dr. Ved channel. I am Dr. P.R. Patel, Professor Head, Veterinary Medicine. In this presentation, we will study a new viral disease, imported disease, Rinderpest. In part 1, we will study synonyms, introduction, etiology, epidemiology, and pathogenesis of Rinderpest. Previously, this Rinderpest was very important disease, but now it has been eradicated from India. But veterinarians who know this disease, anytime it may come to India from the neighboring countries. Rinderpest and famous synonym is cattle plague. Previously, there was very high mortality and morbidity, just like a plague. And because many animals are dying and many animals are affected, just like a plague, so it is named as cattle plague. Rinderpest or a cattle plague is an acute, highly contagious viral disease caused by morbillivirus. The commonly affected hosts are even-toed ungulates, means animal whose toe is bifid or two toes, generally of Artiodactyla. Rinderpest is primarily a disease of cattle and buffalo. Remember this thing. It is a main disease of cattle and buffaloes. Primary affection is to cattle and buffaloes. And to a lesser extent, affect sheep and goats and wild ruminants. The disease is characterized by severe necrotic stomatitis. It causes necrosis of the epithelium and inflammation also of the buccal mucous membrane. Necrotic stomatitis, characteristic finding of this disease. Not only this, but it causes the inflammation of the intestine, gastroenteritis, and erosion of the mucosa of the respiratory and digestive tract. There is dehydration and severe diarrhea is also a characteristic, and many a time there is dysentery. The feces contain blood, so dysentery is also an important sign of this Rinderpest. Etiology: the disease is caused by morbillivirus, belongs to a family Paramyxoviridae. The virus is negative strand RNA virus. This virus has got a single serotype. Single serotype, only one serotype. But various phenotypes, pathotypes, that causes various types of pathology, various pathotypes. These pathotypes vary in great virulence and pathogenicity. Variety of virulence. The word virulence means the capacity of the virus to produce severity of the disease. Pathogenicity means the ability of virus to produce the disease. So based on this variation of virulence and pathogenicity, there are many pathotypes which produce a variety range of the various type of the symptoms, right from subacute, acute, peracute, and to subclinical, chronic also. But peracute and acute disease are more commonly observed. The virus has got antigenic and immunologically related to few viral diseases or few viruses. It is antigenically or immunologically similarity to measles virus, canine distemper virus, and recently observed to PPR virus, and that is called as MRDP complex. Remember, this is MRDP. They are antigenically and immunologically related. M means measles, R means rinderpest, D means canine distemper, and P means PPR. Continue here the etiology. The virus grows in sheep, goat, rabbit, hamster, and bite mice. The virus grown in chicken embryos by intravenous or through chorioallantoic membrane route. The cytopathogenic effect is produced in the cells from cattle, sheep, goat, chick embryo, pigs, hamsters, and men. This cytopathogenic effect consists of a large, well-defined multinucleated giant cell. It is known as Cincia. Cincia is a large cell, it is a well-defined cell, it is multinucleated giant cell. It is aggregation of many cells, Cincia. Epidemiology. Susceptible hosts are primarily cattle and buffaloes. Remember, it is a disease of cattle and buffaloes. In cattle and buffaloes, young cattle are more sufferers and severely sufferers. The crossbred and purebred exotic cattle also are severely affected. And to a lesser extent, the sheep, goat, wild ruminants, especially wild buffaloes and giraffe, rarely affected. In India, the hill gibbon cattle are more susceptible because they have less immunity, while the plain gibbon cattle are suffering more because of the some more immunity. So hilly jabu cattle are more susceptible in comparison to plain jabu cattle. Rinderpest is endemic in African countries and Middle East countries. Friends, remember important thing here. Rinderpest is eradicated from India. Now there is no disease in India. But veterinary officers and veterinarians must have a knowledge about this disease, because any time this disease may come from the other countries. So this is important. Otherwise, from India, this great achievement by veterinarian, they have eradicated a very serious disease, a plague-like disease. Congratulations to all veterinarians. Credit goes to veterinarians for eradication of this disease. we'll see the transmission through direct contact with the infected animal, through aerosol, through air, and enters the aerosol droplets through inhalation route, through ingestion of contaminated food and water. But this type of transmission is rare. Mostly aerosol route is more common, and main source of infection is feces, because whole GI tract is infected. So the virus excreted in feces. So feces is the main source of infection for the healthy animals. Coming to the important part, pathogenesis, how this virus produce series of pathological changes in the body and how this pathological change exhibit the symptoms, that the clinician can understand from studying of the pathogenesis. The virus enters into the body through inhalation or ingestion. So first the virus settle in the nasopharyngeal mucosa. Through inhalation and ingestion, first the virus settle on a nasopharyngeal mucosa. The virus has got affinity to lymphoid tissues and epithelial cells of alimentary and respiratory system. Again, I am speaking, virus has got a great affinity to lymphoid tissue and epithelial cells of alimentary tract and respiratory system. So there is invasion of epithelial cells of respiratory and gastrointestinal tract mucosa. Then the virus invade local lymph node. The virus has got affinity or tropism for lymphoid tissue and mucous membrane of the GI tract. So mostly these parts are affected. Continuation of the pathogenesis. Gradually from this, the virus spread, disseminate throughout the body. Spread throughout the body. And the virus cause destruction of lymphocytes, which results decrease of leukocyte numbers. Condition is called as leukopenia, reduction in number of leukocytes, leukopenia. And because of this multiplication and dissemination of virus, it causes high fever. So initially there is high fever for 5 to 6 days. And the reason I already told you, because of the dissemination, spread, and multiplication of the virus in the body. Then after 5 to 6 days, the temperature drops down suddenly. Then there are characteristic lesions, necrotic stomatitis, inflammation of mucous membrane of buccal cavity, and type is necrotic type. Inflammation of the intestine, especially large intestine, enteritis. This causes severe diarrhea. Many times the diarrheic feces is with blood in severe cases. there is severe destruction of epithelial cells, and that cause the erosions in the mouth and in the gastrointestinal tract. There is great destruction of the mucosal epithelial layer in the mouth, and this dead flakes of epithelial cells, they appear a bran like structure deposits in the mouth. This is also a characteristic finding for the diagnosis of rinderpest. I am speaking again, because of the great destruction of the mucosal epithelial layer, they removed from their normal position and it appears just like a flake like, just like a bran like. That deposit is observed in the mouth. That is a diagnostic in many cases. Friends, need not to say, to share the information. I have told so many times to share the information, and now many are sharing the information and I am getting the overwhelming response that now many are subscribing my channel and they are observing also. But still further requested to share this information, to provide the service to the animals and to the farmers. To grow this channel, requested to subscribe this channel. Thank you very much for observing the video. Next time I will come with Rinderpest Part 2. Thanks.